In this tutorial, I will be building a reactive addition example, and I will start backwards. So this is the application that we built. And so in take one, I built a non-reactive addition example where change is not propagated. And in take two, I turned take one into a reactive addition example where change is propagated. And in take three, I turned take two into a reactive addition example using RX Java. I will start by creating a new Java project. And here I will create a driver class with the main method, and that's going to be in this package. And for the purpose of this tutorial, I will also create this class a variable that represents a variable name and a variable value. And I will initialize the var value to 0 and the var name to null. And let me create getter and setter for each one of those. And I will have a constructor that sets the var name and the var value. And I will generate hash code and equals method based on the var name, and let me move those down here. Now going to the driver class, and in the main method I'm gonna have a list of a variable, and I'll have a buffered reader in order to read the command prompt input. And I'll be reading that input in a while always true loop. So first I'll prompt the user for a variable name. And, let me define those up here. So an instance of a variable and a var name and a var value. So I'll use buffered reader in order to pick up the var name, and if that var name is equals to exit, then I'll go ahead and break out from this loop. Otherwise, if that var name is empty, then I'll do a continue, which means I'll go back and execute this loop. Next, I'll prompt the user for a var value. And I'll pick up that var value in a try catch block. So in case there is a number format exception, I'll do a continue. So I'll go back and execute this loop from the beginning. And I'll instantiate an a variable based on the var name and the var value. And I'll go ahead and add that a variable to this list of a variables in case that variable is not already there. And I'll print out the list of all the a variable in this list. So I'll do variables.stream dot map to double. So I'll map each one of those a variables to the var value of that a variable, and so I'll get doubles, and I'll go ahead and do a sum on those doubles, and I'll add this here. And this up here. And let me go ahead and save all and test run it. Let's say x and the var value, let's say 1. And let's enter a var name y and var value 2. So adding those two is going to give us 3. And if I go z and value is 3, so adding those 3 will give us 6. Now if I try to change the value of x, so var name is x and let's say the value is 2. So now we should get 7, and we only get 6. So change is not propagated. So let's go ahead and fix this. And to do that, let me copy this package and paste it. And call it take 2. So here I will not change the A variable class. As for the driver class, let's first change this. So it's going to be a reactive example where change is propagated. And here instead of this statement, I'll have those two statements. So if the instance of a variable is already in this list, then I'll go ahead and get that instance in the list and set the var value on it to be the a variable dot get var value from here. Otherwise, I'll go ahead and add that a variable instance to this list. And I will also print out the var name and the var value for each a variable instance in that list. And this should do it. Let's go ahead and test run it. So let's say x is 1 and y is 2. So we have x is 1 and y is 2, and the added variables is 3. And let's say z is 3. And here we have the 3 variables and the added variables. Now let's change the value of y. So let's say y is 3. Now the added variables should be 7. And here we go. And let's change the value of x. So make it 2. And the added variables is 8. If we do the same thing for z and make it 4, we get 9. And let's add another variable. Let's say t. And let's make it 5. And here we go. And let's exit. Next, let me go ahead and turn this into a reactive example using RxJava. So let me go ahead and copy this package and paste it here. Let's do a take 3. And I need to use Rx Java jar. So let me go to the previous project where I put the jar that we downloaded in that project. So let's copy it and paste it here. And let's close this one. And do right click and properties. And Java build path and add jars, and we will add that Rx Java jar. So here a variable would stay the same, and we will add another class. So simple observer. This will implement observer coming from the Rx package, and by doing that we will have those three methods. So in the onError I'll just print this error statement, and let's change this to a variable. And here, let's print the var name and the var value on that a variable. And in the uncompleted method, I'll go ahead and print the added variables. So let's go to the driver class and take this list and put it here and make it public and static. So we have driver.variables, and in that variables list I'm gonna do a stream and then map to double, and I will pick up the var value on each one of those a variable instances, and then I'll do a sum on all those var values. And next, let's go to the driver class. And let's change this to a reactive example with RX Java. And here I will have observable and observable dot from this variables list, and I will instantiate a simple observer from here. And here I don't need those two lines, and instead I'll have the observable variables dot subscribe and pass in simple observer. And let me go ahead and test run it. Say X and 1 and Y and 2 and V and 3, and let's go back and do X to be 9, and here we go. So X is 9, Y is 2, and Z is 3, and the added variables is 14. And if I change Y to 10, we will get the added variables to be 22. And let's add another variable. So K, and let's make it 7. And let's go ahead and exit. And let's go ahead and fix one thing. I don't need this one here, since I have it over here.